Society's gullibility worries me. That's what worries me a lot more than Trump's policies themselves. It's how people react to some of the things that he says. Not all people, obviously, but you've got the absolute antis and the absolute fours. There doesn't seem to be much in between. So, you know, Trump will say, oh, there's probably, you know, 3 million people, of, you know, voting illegally, voter fraud, people that are dead or whatever, right? Ineligible to vote, but they voted anyway. 3 million, he brings up this number to try to satisfy, it would seem, to satisfy in his head this terrible feeling he has because, you know, he lost by almost 3 million votes in the popular vote. But you know, that's fake news, apparently. And so lately he says, you know, that I mentioned, you know, any poll that says something negative, about Trump's policies are fake news. If you can't see what's messed up about what he's doing there, I don't know what to tell you. People were saying, well, you know, someone was saying in comments, oh, all presidents have, you know, stated negative things about the media, yeah, but not that it's fake news. They may just dislike it. They may make a slightly negative comment about it, but nothing like what Trump is doing here. Nothing like it. Trump wants to be able to make up his own facts, and then he believes these facts. And then he wants to waste government money to, you know, try to prove this conspiracy theory he has true. Just about everything that he says, people are like, well, you know, well, we should consider this. So we should consider this. Some of you are so brainwashed. So brainwashed that if Trump said, well, we shouldn't be demonizing homeopathy, you know, as much as we have, you'd probably say, well, you know, maybe we should consider not demonizing homeopathy quite as much. You know, we're not saying to, you know, make it as important as regular medicine, you know, it's fake news that homeopathy is absolutely not effective. And you know, if you want to talk about it and the placebo effect, well, no, that I don't want to bother reading reports. You know, do the same thing as Trump. Trump, who doesn't want to read reports, doesn't want to read legislation before he signs it. He just has some people standing behind him. Sign this. Yes, it's good. Yes, it's good. Sign this. Oh, okay. Should I sign this? Even says it like a little kid. Should I sign this? Mommy, should I sign this? You know, look at the footage. And so, you know, it's just, I'm sorry, if your response to Trump saying that any polls that come out that say negative things about him are fake news, you are worshiping Trump. You are worshiping Trump. Well, what if the polls might actually happen to be wrong? That doesn't mean, he doesn't know all the polls that could have been done. He doesn't know any of that, but he's making the statement that any that come out are going to be fake news. Okay, news flash for you. About a third of the things that Trump says is fake news. I mean, you could call it a lie, but he actually believes the lie. You know, he can make up his own facts, then he believes it, then he can shove it out. And, you know, well, we should really consider this because Trump said it. So, I mean, if Obama had even done 1/1000th of this, people would be screaming bloody murder. But it's, oh, Trump, it's Trump. Trump's here to change our system, so we need to believe what he says. You know, believe that the things he says are true. So when people will report on the things that Trump says, the people reporting it are told that they're saying fake news. So it's some of you are essentially stating that the only real news is stuff that comes from Trump's mouth. This is scary stuff. This is scary stuff. This is what has people concerned. Not Trump's decisions themselves. It's the way people are reacting to this. I am astounded at the Trump worship. It's like he's a cult leader, and you're just like AIU's fans. Yes, yes, master. What are we going to do next? What are you going to do next? I mean, it's fucking crazy. I never thought in my life I would see that many people just, I don't know, it's like your eyes have gotten glazed over and you're just like, nee. Ah, look, pretty shiny thing. Now, granted, you know, I want to try to cover both sides of this if I can. Obama was a great orator. He could come up with an amazing speech on the fly. Okay. And his ability to communicate in that way is what allowed him to do terrible things. Is what allowed him to do some of the awful things he did in the Middle East. He could just sweet talk anyone into whatever. That was his thing. And people would just kind of go, some people would go with what he says because they're like, well, look at how beautifully he worded it. Well, it couldn't be bad. Look at the things that he said. And there was that aspect to Obama. Okay. With this. This is a different mindset altogether. This isn't a thing of, you know, this person just said something impressive. It's just your eyes glaze over and, yes, everything you say is good because if we disagree with what you say, we'll be supporting fake news, we'll be fake news. We can't be fake news. Let's not be fake news. We must support what Trump says or we are fake news. We must not be fake news. Please insert brain. I'm astounded at it. Just utterly astounded at it. If Trump was or is a dictator, or if he wanted to be a dictator, you guys are the ones that would be allowing him to do such. If Trump is a dictator, you'd just be giving him the thumbs up. Cool. That's great. And you don't think that's concerning. You don't wonder why some people on the left are just freaking out. What are you doing, people? And it's because of this, because of these people with their eyes just sort of glazed over. And people like, you know, that guy T, he's going to be against anything that anyone does to try to build up a reasonable left. You know, it's like you're telling people, go out and riot because we're not going to listen to or even look at anything that you say unless you do. If you try to say it verbally, it's fake news. It's fake news, fake news, fake news, fake news. I'm just in awe. I'm in awe of the gullibility of people. Whether or not Trump is a dictator, I'm watching before my eyes the reason why Hitler was able to come into power. I'm watching the reason before my eyes, just right here, live before my eyes. Well, not necessarily live, but, you know, I'm watching it happen in front of me. I'm watching the reason why Hitler was able to come into power. I'm not saying Trump is Hitler. I'm saying that the way people are acting is what would allow someone like Hitler to come into power. I've never been more concerned for the country as a result. It's either you're supposed to march lock and step with Trump, or you're fake news, or you're just salty, or something on that order. I'm sorry, this is scary stuff. Trump is like a cult leader. Whether he's trying to be or not, that's what he's become because of the way that people are reacting to him. Now consider this possibility, okay? I just want to think you to think about some of the ramifications for this stuff that's happening, okay? And the reason why it's important. If these things continue to be done and said, and certain sides of the population gain popularity, and the left has no recourse at that point other than the rioting, because people aren't listening otherwise, because it's all fake news. That's when the Trump administration could say, people are not to state those types of opinions anymore. This would include any sort of identity politics outside Christian identity. That's when something could be enacted that would essentially do the same thing that was passed in Russia in June of 2013. See, technically, what passed in Russia in 2013 isn't really an anti-gay bill, but it's anti-being able to show that you're gay publicly. The law essentially made being an SJW illegal. And that's what we're headed for if these patterns continue, where eventually the left's voice will not be able to be heard anymore. We will literally not be allowed to voice that kind of thing anymore, because it will be getting associated with the violence. And because violence is always considered bad by, you know, even though it was kind of necessary for a number of things in our past to have actual justice. I mean, even the Stonewall riots, there have been a lot of riots throughout history that have made change. But we're heading in a direction right now where it's just not going to be allowed, and statements against the upcoming mindset will all be considered fake news. When I discussed talking about things that we could do to news, you know, some requirements, I'm hoping that we can shove forth some regulations on media to be more factual, or they can't call it news. But if we can tackle this with some laws before Trump does, we might be able to have a salvageable situation. It is my view that Trump is eventually going to pass something that will limit media. And there will be some ramifications in there that will be very unfortunate. Unfortunately, I don't think Trump is stupid. I think he's very, very intelligent, and he knows exactly what he's doing. Is he Hitler? No. But I think we're on our way to making left values so demonized to the point where those values will start to be looked at as terrorist values, where leftism will be considered terrorism. And these are the patterns that I'm seeing in front of me. So while you know, push forth this element of, well, violence can never be the answer. Well, when people on the left are made to feel like they're not being listened to at all because anything that they say that comes from the left is considered fake news, what do people have left? They don't have anything left. This is why this stuff is so important to talk about. When you're just going, oh, this is fake news on just about anything that it that says anything negative about Trump, and Trump is saying that anything that says something negative about him is fake news, we're heading down a road that so again, no, Trump is not Hitler. Trump is not going to be singling out a people based off of a religion. He's not going to single people out based off of a race. He will be singling out, most likely, a mindset of anything that's against him, and making sure that anything, no matter whether it's significant or trivial, are looked at the same. Sort of a zero tolerance policy. And some of you are just giving him the thumbs up to do this. Try to look at what we're dealing with right now from a historical perspective. If you were reading about these happenings as something that happened in the past, what would you think is next? So before you start criticizing the left for being very, very angry, abnormally angry, just try to look at this from a historical perspective. Just try, just a little bit, just a wee little bit, you know? Please. This Trump cult mentality is terrifying. Terrifying. And there's going to be a large percentage of us who are going to continue to push against it. Trump is the kind of guy, and we can see this, we can see it blatantly, he gets offended at Saturday Night Live skits. Okay, in his mind, he views these things as slander or libel. If he starts to expand on, you know, slander and libel laws, you should have a lot of concern. But you know what some of you are going to do? You're going to say, well, you know, people shouldn't be able to say things that aren't necessarily true about someone. So people can't even do conjecture? Where do you draw the line? That's a can of worms I don't think you want to open up. You know, something about a joke about a public figure. Well, you know, if it's really saying something that's untrue, those will be the things that people will argue. But it's, you know, of course, these same people were fine when it was being done, you know, against Obama. That's not a problem. But how dare you do it to your savior, Trump? Trump will save us from those mean, nasty SJWs. Terrorism. 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 And when Trump finds a way to stop this from happening, it won't matter what he's done to stop it from happening. As long as he stops it from happening, he will be viewed as a hero, and all of the blame will be put onto the left. Who cares why people become terrorists? Who cares? We have to destroy the people who could become terrorists. That's going to be the mindset. This will end up resulting in any sort of left that goes left of center will be considered a terrorist mindset. It will be an attempt at literally re-establishing what the center politically this country is. And the only people that will fall outside of that will be considered terrorists. I don't want to see the things come true that I talk about in this video. See, if things go the way it seems like it might, when the left or some people will put everyone in the category of SJW, anyone that's angry, anyone that joins in some of the protests that may end up in some parks be riots, you will start to justify laws going against freedom of speech in order to stop the violence. It may not be something where it's all about people not saying anything bad about Trump. Could be about what is seen as, from some Christians' point of view, it's to stop the systematic oppression of Christians from their viewpoint, from their standpoint. And so I ask, will we survive this? If this is our future, will we survive it? Knowing what possibilities could be in the future, do you still hold the same stance? Did you even think about the possibilities of the things I mentioned in this video? We are more likely, during this Trump presidency, to have martial law declared in a number of places than we ever have. It's no wonder why some people are going back to religion. You know, Brett Keane, Eve Real. Will it be Autopsy 87 next? Maybe Live Life 8072 next? Who's gonna go back to religion next?